No hold back what the Lord has given you.
Thank you, God.
Preach the gospel in season and out of season. Reprove and rebuke. We are living in a day where people don't want to hear the gospel of Jesus.
That's right.
So my brother, I charge you to preach the gospel. When you feel like it and when you don't, I charge you to live holy and righteous.
Yeah.
Remember that this certificate means nothing if your lifestyle doesn't match up. I don't care how good you can orate words and how good you can preach. If your lifestyle don't match up with your lip style, you have brought shame to God's name. Remember, your job is to bring fame to the name of God. It should never be about you. It should never be about how well you preach. It should never be about how many people shout. It should be about, did God get the glory in what I said? God doesn't get the glory. And all of your preaching and living would be in vain. There was a song that I sing quite often. I learned when I was a child. Live in me, Jesus.
Yes.
Have your way in me. For I may be the only Jesus this world may ever see. Live in me, Jesus, and have your way in me. Reverend Summers, if you would grant him this. He would give him that certificate. Then, my brother, I give to you the star book for ministers. You need to read it. You need to get well versed with what's in it. Ministry is more than just preaching. There are people who need you. People who need you on your job. You need to know how to talk to folks who are going through. Because a lot of cliches we use when people are dealing with bereavement and sickness shouldn't be used. It doesn't help people. It hurts them. It hinders them. So they got to read. They got to be studied. Workmen need not to be ashamed. Rightly divide the word of truth. When you are ordained, you will then take with you some. You will take this to do weddings and funerals, and it gives you some knowledge on Christian ministry, on the Lord's Supper, marriage. It gives you scriptures on comfort and grief. You need to read this book. You can take it everywhere you go. Then, finally, I present to you. Would you play anointing phone on me? I finally present to you the gift that we all gave today. This is for you. Get you some books. You need to buy a robe if you need to buy a collar. You need to buy some oil. This is given to you for that cause. We all sold into your ministry. You know why we sold into your ministry? Because we believe in you. We don't give money to people we don't believe in. And I know your mother's not here, but your mother believes in you. And we believe, hallelujah, that the same Jesus who told Lazarus to get out of the grave has the same power to say, tell Elder Shirley Pennance to get up out of that day. Bishop will come, Bishop Wall, and other ministers, you will come, and we're going to anoint you Now, I do know that some people don't agree with being anointed in your initial sermon because you're not being ordained. I don't agree with that. That's formality. You need to be prayed for. You need to be covered in the anointing oil. You were anointed. You all lay your hands on them. Anointing fall on me. Gospel of Jesus Christ, who has accepted the call to stand when others don't want to stand. I thank you for the anointing and the power of the Holy Ghost. I pray that the anointing and the Holy Ghost will rest upon him in the name of Jesus, that he will go places that others could not imagine, that he will speak your word in the name of Jesus, that lives will be changed. Lives will be transformed by his ministry, not only by his preached word, but by his lifestyle. In the name of Jesus, I pray for strength in the name of Jesus. For those lonely nights, in the name of Jesus, I pray for strength when ministry has become too much. In the name of Jesus, gird him, hold him with your right hand, which is your power. In the name of Jesus, double in anointing, give him more power, give him more preaching power. In the name of Jesus, we thank you for what you're doing in his life. We stand and support him in the name of Jesus. We give you the glory for what shall come from this day forward in the life of Minister Darris Vaughn. We give you the praise in Jesus' name. Amen. And thank God.